sick. Yep.
What up? Great.
Nice.
Good to see you.
Yeah, you too. You're gonna have to hang these things to park yourself.
Oh shit. Oh yeah.
All right. Strap.
Nice. That sounds shut.
Cool.
Oh yeah, we're gonna roll so I don't get busted just sitting here.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. How's it going?
Good.
Nice.
Yeah. How's your day been?
Honestly, pretty amazing with air conditioning.
Oh, like, cool.
Yeah, it's just been a total game changer.
That's great.
Air conditioning. My phone says it's 95 degrees, so.
Yeah, it's pretty hot. Yeah, my car is right there.
Perfect. There it is. Worked out great. It's like really convenient.
Yeah. Oh man, so my third time in a large truck.
Oh yeah, first time with a trailer, right?
Yeah, doing any work.
Wow.
So we're probably at, right now I'd say we're about 90,000 pounds, maybe 94.
Total?
Total pounds.
Gross.
Yeah. Gross weight. Yeah. Nice. Yeah, it's actually not like incredibly loud with the windows shut either. I mean, for like any distance you'd want earplugs, but it's not like you'd have to shout at each other too badly.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
No. So yeah, the residential areas, you can see we're kind of gaining speed now. These residential areas, you're not supposed to use the Jake brakes at all, so I just kind of try to keep it slow and just give it a little break.
Yeah.
You're here.
Nice too. Yeah.
And luckily, these speed bumps are super mellow.
Yeah.
But, so this morning I did some of the loops I was talking about where, so right now they're digging out 2 feet below the like road base surface of the highway that they're replacing because they have a bunch of soft spots. I think there's like random moisture.
Damn.
So they're having to dig down farther than they thought, remove this material and bring in material to replace it with.
Oh, wow.
So this morning I was hauling this stuff out, dumping it at this dump site that you'll see in a minute, and then driving over to a gravel pit, picking up the material that they're putting underneath, which they call granular borrow. Not sure what exactly what that means. It's something
borrowing,
it's different than road base, but yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Maybe YouTube knows.
Yeah.
But we filled that hole and now they're having to play catch up with the excavator to dig out more. You'll see it on the way back here. You'll go through the whole job site, so.
Cool.
So now we're just kind of doing the back and forth, which is not quite as exciting.
Yeah.
But it's still kind of cool.
Yep.
Not too many hills.
Yeah, that's good.
No, actually it is good. It's like way chill in the vehicle.
Yeah.
Ideally, I could do it up the hills.
Darn right.
But it's going well.
So the truck's doing great?
Yeah, better and better every day. I've been putting little money and work into it every weekend, so.
Yep, that's great.
Yeah, it's, you know, like right now it's like 100% fully functional. Say the only couple things are the radio doesn't work, but that's fine. So I use Bluetooth, your thing, and that's it, really. Yeah, that works.
Cool.
Yeah, that's the CB. That's off right now.
All right. So cool. All right.
Cool.
Yeah, it's comfy in here. It feels great.
It's pretty good. Sometimes the driver's seat's pretty worn, like the cushion is pretty collapsed. So someday I'll replace that.
Yeah. Would you swap it out with a used one or a new one?
I'm not sure, honestly.
I might
try to find a used one.
Yeah, I'm sure a new one costs a lot.
Yeah, or, I think over $1,000.
Does anyone strip them down and rebuild them for a grand or something?
Not sure. I'd probably get a sweeter one than this anyway.
Yeah, technology has improved since 96. What year is it?
96.
96, yeah. 96 is a funny year because that's right when they went from OBD1 to OBD2 with cars, so everything was like weird that year, in my opinion. And there was no BMW 5 Series. but yeah, 96 is a cool year. Alright. Yeah, this thing is such a beast. Yeah, I've never experienced this on the road. I can't really believe it. So how much weight is behind? Like 70,000?
Just the trailer, you mean? Yeah, like probably 70,000 pounds on the trailer. The truck weighs 20,000, pretty much even.
Yeah.
So the trailer's probably about 70.
Very cool.
All right, we'll get this foot on the floor at all times. Okay. Trying to get anywhere in this thing.
Yeah.
That's all she's got.
Signs as we go under them.
So this is, we're just coasting along right here, no throttle, it's a slight downhill.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah, the air ride is very nice. So it's just air ride seats, not the cab?
The whole cab's air ride too.
Well, yeah. That's basically all trucks after a certain date have that, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Like 90s.
Yeah, one thing that I will do eventually is remove the dashboard and then just put it back in because there's the whole thing squeaks so much, you can hear it.
Yeah, yeah.
Someday I'll get to that.
Yeah.
It's kind of a lot of noise. If that noise was gone, it'd actually be pretty quiet in here.
Yeah, it's not bad.
On a smooth road, it's not bad.
Yeah, it's not bad.
So we've got this turn as we go on I-15 north here. It's a little bit of a downhill, so we'll have to slow down for that one a little bit.
Cool. Jake brake.
Window up or down, and do a little window down if you want the full effect.
Try both.
We'll have some more with the window up, so maybe we'll go window down. Just,
yeah,
I don't really go over above like 55 or 60 when I'm loading on these highways.
Yeah.
It's really
makes sense. It's pretty bumpy and stuff.
Yeah, and also just 70 feels a lot faster than 55 when you're loaded.
Oh yeah. Yeah, all I've ever hauled was my car using the box truck, and I found it to be fairly terrifying. Yeah, I just...
It goes like really straight down the road. It's stuff with a load, especially.
That's great.
Wow. Salt Lake.
Yeah, it's very comfortable having air ride. Very nice feeling.
Yeah, I've tried it a little bit, but if I go up even a little bit, I just can't really reach the pedals.
Oh, yeah. How long is the trailer? 50 feet?
This one's a little less than that. I'm not even sure, honestly. Probably somewhere around 46 or 48 or something.
Cool. Downpipe thing failed yet?
I'm ready for it too.
Yeah.
It's hanging in there.
Should be a cheap enough fix.
Yeah.
If you have the capital, would you swap out your turbo? It does look pretty old.
No. I asked the mechanic about it. He said wait until it stopped and build the boost.
Okay, cool. Yeah.
He said these F14 turbos are, he said it's pretty rare for it to catastrophically fail.
Good.
Yeah. He said it'll just like start losing. Starts burning oil or anything, it's oil cool. No, I specifically asked him, he was in here a bit this past weekend, and he said he definitely would. It's cool, he's very pragmatic.
Yeah.
He was like, no waste your money, man.
Nice.
Like, wait till it stops working as well.
Cool, good. Good stuff. Yeah, I love the perspective of being this high off the ground. It's really, really cool.
Nice, yeah.
I like everything about it.
Yeah, you can see like traffic stuff coming way faster. Yeah. Like if there's a, brake lights, you can see all the brake lights rather than just the ones in front of you.
Yeah, yep. I consider my Juke to be high off the ground because it's like 4 inches taller than a sedan, but this is what's up. So yeah, this truck's noticeably a tiny bit taller off the ground than the modern trucks and most trucks, it seems like.
Yeah, it's kind of got like the most ground clearance, and then actually it had 22.5 wheels and tires on it, and I swapped them out for 24.5,
sick,
which gave it about an extra inch and a half of ground clearance.
Yeah, yeah, we are high off the ground. It's pretty great.
We're looking like we'll be looking down. Oh, that goes pretty tall.
Yeah.
They call this a flat top, so it doesn't have a tall sleeper.
Yeah, flat top.
So I kind of like the look of the flat top.
Yeah. It's got to save you a tiny bit of fuel.
Depending on what trailer, maybe.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Cool, so you said you cruise around at like 10 PSI, but it goes to 25 PSI max.
Well, yeah, right now, yeah, it's just holding 10 PSI of boost. On flat ground maintaining speed.
Yeah.
So it's nice to not be in full boost all the time, but there are times when you have to just hold your foot on the floor for minutes.
Yeah, minutes, nice.
Minutes, yeah.
Full boost.
Or like even longer.
Yeah.
When it's cold out, well, I don't worry about holding wide open for like 10 or 15 minutes. yielding as much boost as usual, and I don't know if that's a function of the hot temperatures or what. It seems variable though, based on RPM, so I don't know. It's hard to say.
Yeah.
Get a little speed up once on this trip here again.
Yeah.
65 right here. That's plenty fast. I'm slow back down.
Yeah.
Like the it cruises comfortably at 60 with the load.
65, you just have to work so much harder. I feel like I'm burning way more diesel.
Yeah, true. Bumps, the air ride is quite luxurious.
Pretty good.
Pretty
yeah.
Great. Yeah. Ever want to conduct a train or whatever? Pilot a train around? How do you feel about trains?
I'd like to ride in one.
Yeah, for sure. Maybe see how they do it in the cockpit.
Yeah,
whatever.
That'd be cool. I actually am fascinated by trains.
Yeah.
I've been able to explore like the engine compartment of one. That's cool.
Yeah, sweet.
North Creek, did you check that train out?
No.
Oh, dude, you can go right all the way through the whole... You're in there with
yeah.
The engine.
Wow.
There's a whole second engine just to start the main engine.
Cool. Yeah, I watch train videos sometimes. All right, here we go.
Check in the air horns a little test.
Yeah, air horns.
All day I just try to be as easy on the vehicle as I can. It's like my main goal at all times.
Yeah.
Not gonna lie, every once in a while too, you mess up a shift and feel bad about yourself.
It happens.
Out here in Amish too, the stop signs are a little bit optional. Dump trailer runs off of PTO, so on the transmission there's a little hydraulic pump that I engage. So you have to push the clutch in and stop the clutch with the clutch brake. Put the pump on, and then there's a switch I have that raises and lowers the actual tub. So you can hear the pump engage, you kind of bog down the engine a little, and then I'm going to flip it up and there it goes.
Oh.
Down all the way, and that's it.
Cool. Awesome. Fun.
unladen. Braden unladen.
And
it's the dustiest day ever out here. Real nightmare with all the dust. But what are you gonna do? There's a fire hydrant. Would an automatic modern truck be any less fatiguing on your hip and stuff? Because you wouldn't be on and off the gas as much? Well, I mean, maybe a tiny bit.
I don't think so. Yeah. I mean, driving a pickup truck messes me up just as much.
True. Yeah, that's all good.
I think a hand throttle could be cool.
Hand throttle, yeah.
Or something.
Yes.
Just not driving a lot, but...
Okay. Maybe a standing... I've thought about if there's a standing driving position somehow.
That'd be cool. Or, yeah.
Oh, actually, what we need, the full-on monster truck setup suspended on bungee cables floating in there, in the air. Probably pretty ergonomic. Someone did this, some nice open differential burnouts over here. Donut. All right. Down the dusty trail we go. Wow.
Jeez.
Can't even see the valley. Last summer so far.
It has been, yeah.
Last June was so bad. And we're doing all right. A few more months and we'll be done.
Yeah, we are. Yeah, I really do think that you would love, like, trucking shit, and even though you might have to get into it slowly, but...
Agreed. Yeah, I've always wanted to.
I think it would be pretty sick for you.
Yeah. I mean, I've been learning about it for a good 5 years, listening to the Trucking Channel every day on SiriusXM and watching trucking YouTube channels, so... I just want to operate a giant diesel engine and travel around and have some freedom and sleep in a vehicle.
Totally, dude.
So we'll see what happens.
I've still been looking a bunch, and there's some shit out there, dude. There's some shit in the Midwest.
Yeah. Good deals.
I'm talking legit vehicles for $10,000.
Damn.
$10,000.
Maybe even with some maintenance done.
Yeah. Like, yeah. In the ad. They say ready to work.
Sweet. Oh wow, look at this dust.
Better slow down.
Yeah. No visibility.
Oh man. Might be changing an air filter soon.
Ouch.
Wow.
Yeah.
This is the new normal. This is Salt Lake now. There's gonna be more and more of this.
Yeah, I gotta escape this valley before it's too late.
What I was starting to say earlier is when we moved to Utah, dude, everything was cheaper here, remember?
Yeah.
Now everything's the most expensive here. It's insane.
True.
Like all this stuff back east, like the cars and trucks are cheaper now. There is like the whole thing of like buying vehicles out here in Utah. It doesn't exist.
Aside from the rust.
It's insane, yeah, the rust. But I'm finding, I'm actually really starting to think I might be driving this thing back this year because there are some trailers back east that are fucking half the price of the shit out here.
Yeah.
Half. I could be saving like $15,000 to $20,000.
Damn.
Which would totally make it worth it, meaning I could easily transport your shit. If I end up getting a trailer out there, I could definitely bring your shit back.
Cool.
But no trouble.
Sweet.
We all even like strap the bikes upright.
Yeah.
Do you ever race other semis like off the line? Like if you're, well, I mean, if you're both going to the same place?
I used to when it wasn't my own truck. But now yeah. I definitely don't. But that's a company truck. That's a company called Hugo Trucking. And like, he doesn't own that truck, so he's just hauling.
Yeah.
You notice the owner operators generally drive a little slower and easier than the guys driving company trucks.
Yeah, makes sense. Wow, this dust is ridiculous right now. Can't see much of anything. Can't see any of the valley. Damn. Oh well. Inside info why it takes forever to do this.
That's the concrete paving machine. It just did this section today.
I've always thought that's a cool machine. You could turn it into a jungle gym when it's done.
Here's our guy that's going to load us. So we have to go along back up the block to the truck.
Oh, so this is what we're doing. Damn, this is cool.
Yeah, we got the four ways on right now. Traffic's really getting slow.
Driven through here, late to work, to many restaurants. It's cool to stop and check things out. Oh boy. Nice and clean in here. You certainly got cleaned up since you got it.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, it hasn't been cleaned in about a month, but yeah. I've been trying to keep it as clean as I can. Oh, it's hard in this dust and dirt in and out of the truck.
Yeah,
but yeah, no, it's... I really am adamant about a clean vehicle. Yeah, usually it's tidy, but slightly dusty. That's pretty much how my vehicles are.
Yeah.
One, two, I guess.
So we're backing up.
So, these tires that you put on here, are they a fairly off-road minded tire?
Or very. Yeah, they're really.
More so than an average semi tire.
Way more.
Way more. That's what I thought.
Yeah, they're like, giant lugs, deep, widely spaced.
Okay, so
they're quite loud on the highway. That's the downside.
And theoretically, a tiny bit less efficient. I'm sure.
Yeah, theoretically,
they pretty much have to be.
Not as great in the snow as some. They make tires that are pretty comparable to like a truck all-terrain tire that might be like a little more well-rounded, but.
Yeah.
Definitely a little less suited for this stuff, especially if you get into some of these muddy spots. When it rains on these job sites, it gets really, really nasty.
Yes. You got your lockers.
Yep.
Yeah.
These tires are the ones that had in stock when I needed tires, and I'm glad I went with them. They're probably the most resistant to like puncture and whatnot.
That's good. Many ply. So the longer the trailer is, the easier it is to back up. Is that? Yeah, that's how it goes.
I would say so. Yeah.
In any case, you're well experienced.
Yeah, it doesn't mean I don't. It's happened so slowly on these, though. It's pretty hard to like really mess it up.
Yeah.
usually it's, you just sometimes don't pull far enough forward if you're trying to turn and back up, and you kind of misjudge where the back of the trailer is.
Yeah, yeah. I've only backed up small trailers. And
more challenging.
Yeah, I've had good and bad days with it.
Fifth wheel trailers are easier also, I think, because like a bumper pull trailer responds the opposite direction of the way you turn the truck. This does also, but like turning the wheel doesn't really do anything to the trailer until you actually go a little bit.
Yeah.
Whereas the bumper pull trailer will jackknife way faster.
Sure.
I explained that a little poorly, but...
Oh, no. So you're just in reverse with the clutch out,
little,
obviously?
Yeah, a little bit of throttle.
Yeah.
I'm on the throttle a little bit.
So reverse is a low gear. Can you, like, split reverse or whatever?
Not in a 13 speed. Oh, okay. In an 18 speed, you can.
Okay.
Someday this truck will have an 18 speed.
Okay,
for
great.
Sure. But not until I need it. Not until it's mandatory.
Yeah.
That was another thing, is I told the mechanic, like, hey, I'm thinking about putting an 18 speed into this. He's like, why? And I said, well, it'd be sweet. He's like, what's wrong with yours? And I said, well, nothing. And he said, you might as well wait till there's something wrong with it.
Yeah, yeah, got to be pragmatic about these things.
Exactly.
Yeah. So at least you don't have to whip your head around like in a snowcat when you're doing this.
Seriously.
So snow versus snowcatting, you've obviously spent too many hours in snowcats. Both hard on your body. Was that hard on your hip, or what was the deal with that?
That was better on the hip.
Okay.
Because you don't have to use your feet for anything, so you
yeah.
can like cross your legs and move
yeah.
around and
yeah.
whatnot. Definitely harder on like the wrists and elbows. If you do it right, though, I think snowcat's a little easier on the body.
Yeah.
It's much more relaxed
yeah.
than driving a truck around in traffic.
Yeah.
I prefer snowcats to
yeah.
trucks.
Yeah.
I don't actually really like driving that much. I mean, it's not like I
right.
hate it, but it's
yeah, I'm questioning.
Certainly not what I would choose to do with my time these days.
I'm questioning my relationship with it, too, because I drive Lyft so often.
Yeah, no, I mean, at this point, the only driving that I would get excited about would be, like, spirited driving on a closed
right.
course.
Yeah, right?
That's
a closed
it.
Course. Yeah, that's the dream, to get you on an actual track. Because I think back to us driving fast on roads, and I'm just like, potentially risky, potentially
and,
expensive.
Oh, and the only thing I'm interested in doing on a road motorcycle is riding on a closed course with protective gear. But that I really want to do.
Ooh, right?
That
true.
Would be awesome.
I would even ride a motorcycle on a safe track
with
all
the
gear.
With the gear, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, just,
you could slide off.
Totally.
No
yeah.
biggie. What was that? He's loading us up?
He's loading us up, yeah. You can. I can see him in my mirror. You might not be able to see him too well. Let's see. Get a little view. It's a Cat 336 excavator. I think that's about a 70,000 pound machine. Don't quote me.
Cool. All right, we're getting loaded up. How long will it take?
Like 2 minutes.
Cool.
Awesome. And then we'll be out of here.
All right. Good job. Yeah, that thing's sick.
Connor. Yeah.
Yep.